see it again. And it's pretty awesome. So I'm only going to use it a couple of times too. Like, it works. It doesn't work in many instances. It's almost like a rush jet, except faster. If you use it for that. Or you can use it as a platform. Basically, it's like if you took the weapons 1, 2, and 3 from Mega Man 2 and you put them all together in one weapon and you turned it into a weapon that actually did damage to enemies, you would get the Super Arrow. Which makes it pretty fucking awesome. But only in limited situations, because it's not like that's your only item to alter terrain traversal. You have all these other options. You got the rush items, you know, pretty well varied, pretty much has it covered. So, you know, not as useful as it could be. So, let's see. I fucked up. I gotta do it again. Hopefully don't get killed by vicious lions. So I guess this would be a good instance to use Super Arrow if you didn't want to use the Rush Coil. But to me, the way I see it is that since Rush Coil is even, like, you know, it's so much less versatile than the Super Arrow, I'd rather use the Rush Coil at every instance that it becomes a viable option. Just because it's less versatile. That's kind of my philosophy. You know? Use the least versatile weapon for the situation, because a more versatile weapon will be more useful later. See, I'm there, I'm using it as a platform. It could be used for a lot of things. You can actually use it, you can fire it and then jump on it, and then ride it all the way across, and not even use the rush jet. But sometimes I miss, and I land and fucking fall into spikes and die. And I don't want to do that, so I use the jet. So now, as you see, I'm in Proto Man's castle, and the boss I'm going to be fighting is going to be like some crazy tank man or something. But they're all, like, I don't know if the bosses I'm going to fight in this castle are all supposed to be like the same boss with just like either different, either like they've been like rebuilt, or like their consciousness has been transferred or something, or if they're just all different entities, because they all look the same. They all look like they either are the same core, and then I just said, fuck you, puzzle. Which, you know, I'd recommend all of you doing that as well, because some of these puzzles, it's like, you know what, you gave me the tools to avoid it, you brought this on yourself. So, like, I wonder if, like, the robots, like, if they're all, like, Darkman robots. Like, they're all just, legs of Darkman. So, like, how Sigma works in Mega Man X, where he's just, like, just pulls out a different body every week. Or if they're just all genuine different robots, they just all happen to look the same. Because, like, you know, keep this guy in mind. Like, look at him. You see him? Sort of little mechanics how he works. And you're going to see the next boss is going to look just like him, except a different color, and he'll have legs. And then the third guy is going to look just like him, except he'll also have legs, and he'll have a blaster on his shoulder. So, like Vile from Mega Man X. But they all look exactly the same. They're just like palette swaps with legs, I guess. And they're all weak to different weapons. But they're all pretty simple. I think the first one and the third one are the hard ones. Because the third one has that same ability that everyone's favorite bosses from Mega Man has, which is the ability to just freeze you in place for no fucking reason. I know I could use the rush coil, but I was lazy. I felt like using that. So, here we go. Now, let's see. Trying to avoid these guys like a boss. Eventually, I get through all this onslaught of shit. Which is really nice when they line up so you can just kill multiple guys in one shot. It's the best. Those are the moments that you live for with Mega Man. This part is notoriously frustrating. where you hit the death spikes, these conveyor belts that lead to death, and every one of them, you have to contend with fucking death dispensers. Like, literally, they're shooting out skulls, they're death dispensers. So getting through that and not dying is, in and of itself, is a fucking hassle. So I have to deal with these crystal skeletons, I guess. Not sure what they're supposed to be. I mean, they kind of bear resemblance like the Hammer Joes from Mega Man 3. Just, they lost a lot of weight, apparently. And, they've changed their arsenal. Instead of hammers, they're using crystals. Let's see. Always got to... Ever since I got killed, you get killed from open pits from random... Ah, fuck. You know what? That's okay. That's okay. I do the whole stage over again, but whatever. I don't give a fuck. I'm Mega Man. You've seen all this before. So now, what can I talk about? Alright, so... The boss of this stage is going to be just like the last guy. He's going to have like a little shield, and he's not going to attack you at all. Which makes him like... I don't know what he's trying to... what they're trying to pull. I'm not sure, like... Some of the AI choices in this game, I'm not really sure about. Kind of questionable. I mean, some of them are, like, really easy. But some of them are, like, really easy because they're just, you know... They're... Like, once you get them... Like, at first, they're hard. But once you get them, they're no problem. And that's, like, a lot of Mega Man games. I mean, clearly... Clearly, when I play this game, just like when you played this game... When I played Mega Man 2, when I played Mega Man 3, at first, I thought they were really hard. And it took me forever, took me several hours to finish it. But then once you beat it, and once you understand how all the enemies work, and how to effectively destroy them all without much effort, it becomes nothing. And that's how a good game should be. You know, you struggle at first, you evolve, you get better, you improve, you learn, and you conquer. And then every time after that, you can just have fun playing the game. You can appreciate it for what it is, and not for, you know, it, you know, frustrating the fuck out of you. So, I guess what I'm saying is every time you play a Mega Man game, you're gonna fucking hate it. Until you beat it. And then you're gonna play it again, and you're gonna fucking love it. So, but in this game, it's really easy, so that relationship goes by a lot faster. You can beat it no problem, much quicker than the other ones. Which isn't to say it's short, it's actually pretty long. It takes a lot of the tropes that were introduced in Mega Man 3 and Mega Man 4, and it's pretty long, it's got a lot of levels. So, you know, but the problem is, like the AI in other games, some of them are just fucking brutal. And some of them are like this right here. It's fucking annoying me. Like, some of the AI in some of the games are just fucking brutal. And it's just hard to contend with. No matter how good you get at it, right? Unless you find, like, a major exploit or something. But in this game, most of the AI is just, like... Some of it's simple, but some of it's too simple. You know? Now here's the boss talking about. This is like the kind of the iconic, if you think of Darkman, he looks like this, I think. I think I'm just basing that off of, he was in the cartoon once. And he was known by Darkman. But he had like crazy abilities that none of these guys ever had. And, he was like way more awesome. And he's made way more statistic. He was basically the Mega Man version of Vile, is what he was. Except he didn't have that cannon on his arm. He was just really sadistic and had all these crazy abilities just to ruin everyone's shit. So he felt like he was a major underling, like a second in command to Wily. Because like you could look at like Proto Man felt like the second in command to Wily, because, you know, that's the way he acted. He was like a sidekick. But you knew that Proto Man was he was not on the same side as Wily was. He was just against the same people that Wily was against. So their enemies were the same, so they formed an alliance. That's kind of why they were together. And also because Wily built Proto-Man, so he had sort of an allegiance to him, but you could see that, you know, because of his programming, it wasn't very good, that it was prone to rebellion, that he didn't hold that, you know, very near and dear, the fact that he was, you know, who birthed him. He didn't have, like, a father complex, even if he tried to use it as a weapon against Mega Man, because mostly all he wanted was, he had a brother complex, so he mostly just wanted to be with Mega Man, or he wanted to destroy him, one or the other. Sometimes it got confused. Sometimes, like, you couldn't tell if he was using that as an excuse to destroy Mega Man, or rather he was sincere. It was all really weird. But anyway, so Darkman felt like if one of Wily's robots was going to be like a true second command and really carry out had the same ideas and goals that Wily had, it would probably be Darkman. But, like, he kind of was kind of passed off as, like, you know, like, he was in, like, I think just one episode, and it was, like, he just passed off as, like, one of the guys, you know, like, hey, Guts Man, Dark Man, go take care of that thing I got you to take care of. Go get that package from the post office. And so he's like, all right, cool. But, like, he kind of assumed, like, a leadership role of sorts, because he seemed way smarter and way more powerful. But, as you probably know, he never appeared again in the show or in the series at all. This is the only time you're ever going to see Darkman is in this game. Granted, you get to fight him 4 times, but it's cool. He's pretty boss. I wouldn't mind seeing him again, especially if he had, like, the fucking weapons that he had, like, in the Mega Man cartoon. He had, like, one weapon, it was it was almost like an electric net. So it was like, who had an electric net? I think it was a guy in Mega Man X4, wasn't it? He had an electric net, and he used it on, I don't fucking remember. But yeah, so it wasn't like a net that was electrified. It was almost like a net made out of electricity or something. I don't really remember. But it was pretty badass, and Mega Man was like, he got caught in a web, and he's like, oh shit, I'm so screwed. What am I gonna do? Which, I mean, granted, I mean, it could be worse. Like, as badass as, like, Electman seemed in the series, where he always seemed like he had Mega Man's number, where he's just like, I'm gonna hit you with this weapon, and you're gonna be fucking paralyzed until I stop hitting you with electricity. Which was a pretty fair assessment, considering how much fucking damage Electman would do in Mega Man 1. You know, he's paralyzed and all, and that's cool, right? That's fine, that's effective. But if Cutsman had just once hit Mega Man... Well, actually, he did hit Mega Man with his blades before. I was thinking, like, you know, like, he cut through, like, entire buildings and shit with his cut. So you'd think, well, it'd be no problem to cut through Mega Man. But he'd actually hit him before, and it just bounced off him, and it just, like, ow. That, like, really hurt. It'd be like if you hit Mega Man with a shoe. That's pretty much what Cutsman's working with. So, I'm gonna commit suicide here, because this guy's kinda hard, and I know he's gonna kill me. You know, I probably could've used an E-Tank and just got myself back in the fight, but fuck it, whatever. I usually play the trope where, like, I have, like, this conservative mindset when I play these games, where I have to conserve everything I've picked up. So that's why I don't like throwing anything away in a game or selling anything because I don't know what I'm going to need. Or I like to keep all my money. I don't like to buy anything because, you know, what if I pick up the item that I just bought or something? I don't know. So, like, in Mega Man, if I still have lives left, I like to kill myself rather than use an E-Tank. Unless, you know, I'm out of lives or, you know, I'm engaged in a a long, prolonged battle, and I don't have any more energy left. But in some cases, I kind of just weigh it out. Like, okay, I have so many E-tanks, and I have so many lives. Which is more important? Which is more expendable? And I had, like, maxed out lives. I don't think I ever died. Like, I died once in that Starman stage, I think, was the only time I died. So, I was due for another death. It's no big deal. And now, we get to fight Proto Man. Or do we? Yes, we do. No, we don't. Or do we? So this is... I'm not sure what they were going with here. I mean, I know it's like, it's no big deal for you to just make a stage that doesn't really have any real objective for like a final boss stage, you know, like the castle. It's just like, you know, here's a portal and here's all the bosses, something like that. Proto Man, how could you do this? He's got me cornered and he kills me in one shot. Now there's a different whistle. Oh shit. And he drops the one and only L tank in Mega Man history. I fucking love the L tank. Wish there were more L tanks. And now I'm using Beat, which is the first time I used it in this game so far. And I'm probably not gonna use it very much. I'm gonna use it later, maybe. But see, this guy isn't so bad. But if you let him hit you, he will do a lot of damage. He's almost like a combination of the first and the second. Except the first one was a lot harder, in my opinion, because I find him really hard to dodge, because he didn't move fast enough for you to dodge him. So now Darkman is dead.